So in this video, I'm going to go over how to conduct a confirmatory factor analysis using Mplus. We're going to go over one confirmatory factor analysis using four variables and another confirmatory factor analysis using less than four variables. So we'll use the less than four variables first. So right here, we've got our data already imputed into SPSS. We have our data file here. We've got our variable names, and then we've got our missing values labeled. Now, the next thing we want to do is we want to tell Mplus which variables we actually want to use. So we'll say use variables are, and then we'll define them. Since we're going to look at one with three or less first, we'll go with TQ. So we've got our three variables there. Now we want to tell Mplus what the model is. So we'll say model, and we'll say TQ, which is our latent variable, is made up of by TQ1, TQ2, TQ3, semicolon. We'll also potentially want to add modification indices and standardized paths to our output. They're helpful in determining which values we may want to remove from the actual model in case they're problematic. So we'll say output colon standardized and mod indices semicolon. So we'll go ahead and save this, and then we'll run it. And here's the output. Now, typically, we want a chi-square that's non-significant, an RMSEA that is less than 0.909, and CFI and TLI above 0.90. Now, as you can see here, with only three variables, we have a chi-square with 0 degrees of freedom. Now, this is just essentially saying we can't get our fit indices with a model like this. We need to change our model a bit. So in order to conduct a CFA using three variables as one of our one of our latent variables, we need to add a second variable. So we will add IQ. IQ1, IQ2. And then we also need to add up here in the use variables, IQ1 and IQ2. We'll go ahead and save this as a second CFA. And then we'll run it. And now we actually have a chi-square statistic, RMSEA, CFI, and TLI. So it looks like the chi-square test is significant. We don't want significance here, but we can get away with significance as long as the other fit indices are met. So if we look at the RMSEA next, it's 0.104, and this is outside of the 0.09 that we want. So in this case, the model is not a very good fit. We could perhaps go down here to modification indices to see where some problematic variables are. And it looks like TQ2 and IQ1 seem to be wanting to be correlated. And if you correlate these terms, that'll end up improving the model. But sometimes it just doesn't make sense, theoretically, to do something like that. So it may just be better to remove one of these questions from the actual CFA, and that might improve the fit. However, let's show you a CFA using four variables. So we'll use PU, and then we also have to change our use variables. We'll go ahead and save this, CFA3. We'll go ahead and run it. And we still have a significant chi-square, but all hope is not lost because our RMSEA is 0.086, and that's good. CFI and TLI are 0.99, which are also good. So in this case, we have a good model fit, and the CFA is successful.